Hey guys, it's just going to be a quick video on how to remove the battery drawer on one of these locked style battery smoke alarm detectors. It's a First Alert SC9120B, by the way, but I think they're pretty much the same for all of the locked ones. So you can see it's chirping. We're going to get started by twisting counterclockwise. And then right here, if you can see, there's a little tab, and you're going to want push that out with a flathead screwdriver, and then you're able to pull this out, and then it'll be easier to work on that way. You can do it up here, but it's just a little bit harder. So I'm going to do that real quick off screen. Okay, now that we got it off, we're going to take this part off, and now normally in a normal smoke detector, you can just pop this and it opens this drawer right here. But since this one is a locked one, and I couldn't find anywhere online to give me a clear answer on how to get it off, it just said to pry in a general direction. I couldn't exactly tell, but I eventually figured it out. See, there is this. It's hard to see from my camera to focus, but right above where my thumb is, there's a pin, and it extends all the way up to here. This is discard battery. You remove the pin under this label. And so it's easy to get a flathead and peel that sticker off, and then you can remove that pin. I'll show you how to do that. So now that I peeled that sticker away, you can see right here that pin, that painted blue little thing, and you just gotta wedge your screwdriver into the top of that and then pop it right out. And you're gonna want to keep that if you ever want to lock it back. So I'm gonna do that real quick. There we go. Eventually managed to pry it out. So you're gonna take this out, and there's your little pin. And when you open this, it's gonna beep one last time, I'm pretty sure, and it will. So we'll open that real quick. There we go. Now it opens like a normal one, and we can take the battery out. Not quite, but there we go. And I'll assume you guys know how to change a 9-volt, and just reverse the process, and you put it right back in. So thank you very much. And here we go. There's the model number. And there we go.